When you think of hockey, you may think of Canada, the Midwest, or somewhere cold.
Lauren Shirley tells us how ASU is changing that perception as they show that Division I hockey belongs in the desert.
Arizona State Sun Devil hockey has been on the rise since the program began its transition in 2014, from a successful club team to the NCAA Division I ranks.
We've been very process-oriented and focused from day one in perfecting all of our processes. We're still evolving, we're still perfecting them, but we have them much more dialed in in so many different ways. And we feel like we're not flying blind anymore. We know what we're getting into in every situation. We know how to prepare for every situation. And that's the biggest change, I think, and difference and probably the biggest reason for our success.
Justin Emerson, ASU hockey beat reporter in 2014, remembers the announcement when the Sun Devils made the move.
It was clear to everybody what was about to happen. And then they announced that they're going to be a Division I program. And it was just... it was the coolest thing.
We never intended for it to go NCAA. That was never the goal. We just wanted to become the very best club program in the country. We did that. We focused on what was in front of us. We became the very best. It caught the right people's attention. And here we are trying to do it again at this level.
This year marks the five-year anniversary since the Sun Devils became a Division I program, and this season is unlike any other that they have ever played. After competing as an independent team, ASU is playing all of their games on the road this year against Big Ten teams, only due to the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic.
It certainly can help our brand even more than we've already helped itself already. Playing against like-minded Power Five institutions only certainly will help, I think, our brand from a business standpoint.
ASU's hockey team has not only experienced success on the ice, but away from the rink as well.
Obviously, we won't have the ability to have our home games there, so that'll affect revenue. But if we're on the road, we also don't have the expense of having to rent a facility and practice there as much as we normally would. I think the key here is to perform well, and as we get into the future and then we move to our new arena in a couple of years and have the avidity and fan engagement that we expect to pull from the last two seasons, and then when we use that to catapult and go into our new facility.
Senior Philip Bunces, who came to ASU from Latvia in 2017, has enjoyed being a part of the program's ascension in the desert.
We've been able to grow and develop, you know, on a daily basis, like week by week, month by month. Literally, like every weekend we get better and better. And over the years, we got some great players coming in. You know, guys are working really hard. I think that's the main reason why we've been able to kind of achieve what we have so far.
The Sun Devil hockey program has been an ongoing success story over the last 5 years. From transitioning from club champions to a Division I program, the support has been there since day one.
Support's been incredible. It continues to grow even through a pandemic.
Emerson remembers the day very clearly, being alongside Vice President of Sun Devil Athletics, Ray Anderson, when he received the call from Don Mullett, a businessman from Wisconsin, whose son had played hockey at ASU that changed the trajectory of the program's future.
When Anderson got the call from the Mullets and from the people that were willing to finance it, I think he took it very seriously. And I think that there was a lot of support once it became clear that this was a real possibility.
The program came from humble beginnings without much fanfare, but success was always in its future.
Professionalism with which Powers and his staff always treated the club program was a good indicator that it was going to be successful at Division I, because they didn't treat it that much different. They've been treating themselves as if they were a Division I program for a long time.
The Sun Devils are not only skating to success in the NCAA, but the sport of hockey has become more popular throughout the Southwest as well.
Yeah, hockey's growing exponentially here. It shows in the high levels that Arizona kids are attaining. The best player in the world from Scottsdale and Austin Matthews. We've had the NHL here for over 20 years and now Division I hockey. We have an American League team in Tucson. We've had a Central Hockey League team in Prescott. It's for everybody, and it's for anyone that lives anywhere to play.
As hockey continues to grow in the Southwest, the Sun Devil program is looking to continue their success in the years to come. I'm Lauren Shirley for Cronkite Sports Report. We still see score.